Got no business here.
Get out of here!
Sending it.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Get out of here! Go, go, go! Come on! Take him!
You ain't welcome here. Get going. That's what I thought. Where was I? I will get the dogs.
Hurt me, please.
No, I can't. You think you're better than me? You ain't better than me! You hear me? You hear me?
Excuse me.
You don't mind all these folks
what
looking
at?
You don't mind all these folks look.
Sorry,
these
about that.
Poor folks.
Hey there,
living
cat.
In such condition.
What?
Possibly. They're right behind us.
Huh? Never like.
Huh? Don't like folks skulking around our business.
No!
Oh, shit!
Oh, shit!
The pigs will be here any minute.
Lincoln, you a sight for sore eyes. Merle's holed up over at Perla's. What I hear, he's pissed as all hell. Wish I could see that asshole's face right about now.
Just so we're on the same page, once I'm in there, I'm killing any motherfucker who gets in my way.
Ain't no one shedding tears for those pricks. You do what you think's best.
I'll be seeing you, Laveau.
Those Dixie assholes thought they could come here and pimp out our women.
Still can't believe one of those jigaboo motherfuckers has the balls to come after us. I think they would have learned after Sandy.
Just a local color show in their upset. Besides, don't see him around now, do you?
I hear there ain't no stopping this one. He's a black demon or some shit.
You need to stop drinking that rot gut. Ain't never been a man I can't deal with.
I'm sorry, Merle, but I weren't even here. I'm just,
motherfucker took some of our best girls. You get that dope in them, they'd suck a potato out of a tailpipe.
What and all? He killed Doc, too.
Fuck him. Any idiot can work a needle. But getting someone to work a cock? Oh, that's another story.
Yes, sir.
Fuck! Goddamn
pussies!
Somebody's tagged me!
Well, what you gonna do, nigger?
This.
Dixie motherfuckers are out of Perlis. Have your men come lock it down.
Good. I'll send some men over to see.
Dixie motherfuckers out of the church, and Richie will have to respond.
In 1966, the FBI recruited me out of college. Chicago was my first assignment, but I was transferred down south in 68. I stayed there until 86, when I was promoted to assistant director of the criminal enterprise branch. I stayed with the Bureau until my retirement in 1999. Oh, there are so many stories about Cassandra. As a girl, she was kidnapped, killed, and brought back to life by a voodoo priest. She watched swamp rats rape and murder her sister. She shot her own father and dumped his body in the swamps. It's impossible to know what's true.
Community needs this place, Mr. Clay. A place for folks to forget their problems and have some fun. Perla would have been proud.
Personally, house has been underwater since that hurricane. But I think they speak in tongue. Don't matter. Word from on high is we stick to the hollow with this shit. My thinking? Old man Marcano don't know Georgie and Richie's got a slinging H. You want to be the one to tip him off?
Fuck that, nah. We'll stick to the hollow.
Finger got going on at the church.
There's all kinds of dope over at the church. If you destroy it, the boss is gonna lose a lot of money.
You can thank me later.
Like a polar black around him. Come on.
Doreen's knocked up again.
Huh. Congratulations.
Like I need another goddamn brat to trip over. Told her to get on the goddamn pill. She's too Catholic for that.
You know what? You're better off doing like I do. Get off at the cat house.
Fuck, probably be cheaper. Of course, if Doreen found out, she'd cut my nuts right off.
Bayou 620, New Bordeaux.
Just move along, Bubba.
You're gonna tell me about the dope operation.
The boss has got enforcers dealing around the hollow.
I might need you. Stay close.
Any of y'all got the time? We got a call about a homicide in the hollow. Dispatch out.
Oh, motherfucker. Stupid fuck! Boy!
What?
Hey, dead body over here!
Don't get over here! I'll see you!
Just shut the hell up about Mama, all right? Every day is the same damn thing with you. She dead and buried and ain't coming back.
That poor boy ain't seen her.
Yeah.
This ain't that skunk weed again, is it?
Shit, man, you know
huh?
I'll be right by it.
Damn thing. Ain't giving up yet.
That shit is shooting.
I've been listening in on old Charlie, and he isn't such a bad fellow. He's more of a kinder, gentler redneck. And as luck would have it, his wife is expecting.
Man in that situation usually doesn't care who he works for, long as he's still above ground.
Poor sap starts blubbering when the two of them talk about names. Right now, it's between Bo Cephas and Thomas Lee. Anyway, his guys have the church locked down, and all of them are more of the
Shoot first, let God sort them out, variety of redneck. You get your hands on Charlie, though. He'll do what he's told without putting up much of a fuss. All your intel's been updated.
You going back to the motel?
After I get something to eat. I'll see you when you're done dealing with these inbred assholes.
George, he'll do if he finds out all our dealers are getting hit.
We'll kill Richie for sure. Probably Charlie and Merle, too.
Fuck. Comes to that, my ass is vanishing.
You again?
George will never find me out there in that swamp.
You, boy. Charlie called in all the boys. We're good. Just need to hunker down and wait for that nigga to come to us.
Y'all settled on a name yet?
Was thinking about Thomas Lee after my old man.
That's got a nice ring to it.
This shit with us getting hit doesn't get settled. My boy might wind up being named something else.
Nah, I won't come to that. Boys will take care of it. You'll see.
Live long enough to raise your family.
Okay, sure thing. Whatever you want.
That's good, Charlie. Real good. Send your men to the First Baptist Church. Those Dixie heathens have been handled.
I'll have some of my men come right over. And thanks.
State your name for the record.
Donovan. John.
Mr. Donovan, you understand that by appearing before this committee, you have explicitly waived your constitutional rights in regards to counsel and self-incrimination.
Sure.
And you further acknowledge that by appearing before this committee, you agree to disclose all information pertaining to the events that occurred in New Bordeaux during the summer and fall of 1968.
I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't.
You were an operative in the Central Intelligence Agency from 1953 to 1969, is that correct?
That's right.
When did you arrive in Vietnam?
August of 1961.
Please describe for this committee the actions you took during your time in Vietnam.
I spent a couple months in Saigon. Then I was transferred to a base in Laos that was operated by the Special Activities Division. We trained and equipped the Hmong and then turned them loose on the NVA. We're running arms and supplies via the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
And you worked with Lincoln Clay in what eventually became the Phoenix program.
Within a year or so, Lincoln was heading up his own PRU. We'd cross over into Vietnam and locate enemy targets and either kill them or bring them back for interrogation. Just thinking about it? Jesus Christ. You wouldn't believe the shit we did to those cocksuckers.
God ain't forgetting what those motherfuckers did to this place, Mr. Clay. I won't tease her.
Watch yourself around my files. There's a system. I know this is personal for you, but you want to kill Sal and that dipshit son of his. You're gonna need to keep your head. Jesus, everything here is either fried, covered in sugar, or both.